Out front tonight, you're not fired. The president talks the tough talk on firing, but when it comes down to it, he isn't saying the two words "you're fired" to someone's face. And tonight, there are real consequences. The White House is still trying to square two completely opposite stories about Veterans Affairs Chief David Shulkin's exit. The White House insists that the Veterans Affairs Secretary resigned, but Shulkin tells CNN that is not true.
General Kelly gave me a heads up that the president would most likely be tweeting out a message in the very near future, and I appreciated having that heads up from General Kelly.
So the tweet fired you?
Yes.
Shulkin's answer very telling about how the president himself handles the big, tough conversations with his most important staff. But it's also significant legally. If Shulkin resigned, President Trump can name his interim replacement. But the president may not have that right if Shulkin is fired, which means any decisions made by Shulkin's replacement now could be challenged legally. That's a problem for the White House. And President Trump's fear of stepping up and telling someone to his or her face that they're fired is a big issue, because Donald Trump's administration is firing people at a record never before seen in at least modern American history. So far, the Trump administration has a nearly 50% turnover rate. And Trump's cabinet itself now holds a record for the highest turnover in a century, according to NPR. That's 100 years, just to be clear. A century, 100 years. Modern American history. Pretty stunning. I mean, look at these names. You're looking at everyone who has been fired or resigned since President Trump took office. This list goes on and on. Yet, in just about every case, it was not the president of the United States who did the firing. The president's former Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson, was fired by Chief of Staff John Kelly, or tweet. His former chief strategist, Steve Bannon, fired by Kelly, as was Anthony Scaramucci. His former FBI director, James Comey, fired by a letter delivered by the president's personal bodyguard. By the way, Comey wasn't even there. He found out from television. The bottom line is Trump won't do it himself, which is a pretty big thing to say about a man who built his celebrity and his brand of toughness that he holds so near and dear on this.
You're fired.
You're fired.
You're fired.
Trump liked to say those words to the cameras, but he admitted to me once that he didn't even like doing it, even then.
Scott, you're fired.
That was very hard. Doing that was very hard.
That was very hard. Is that why, after months of publicly humiliating Attorney General Jeff Sessions and letting him twist in the wind, the president would rather send tweets like this one today than actually fire him? Here's the tweet. So sad that the Department of Justice, in quotes, and the FBI are slow working or even not giving the unredacted documents requested by Congress. An embarrassment to our country. Is it why Scott Pruitt, the embattled Environmental Protection Agency administrator, is still hanging around despite new revelations that he stayed in the apartment of an energy lobbyist on Capitol Hill? Those revelations are why former Trump ally and New Jersey governor Chris Christie says Trump should step up and fire Pruitt.
And if Mr. Pruitt's going to go, it's because he should have never been there in the first place. Listen, I don't know how you survive this one.
So far, though, Trump not pulling the trigger on Pruitt. And did you hear something else Christie just said there? He also said Pruitt never should have been there in the first place, which raises a really important question, that it's not just that the president doesn't know how to fire someone. Christie is also saying that the president actually doesn't know how to hire the right person. Look at all the people who have been accused of wasting taxpayer dollars on things like private jets and vacations. Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin, remember his wife posting a photo of them walking off a government plane on the day of the eclipse? Former Health and Human Services Secretary Tom Price, Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke. And then there's Urban and Housing Development Secretary Ben Carson. Remember the $31,000 dining room set? And these guys are still there. Trump, the businessman, said that he would change Washington. But can he really make good on that promise when he can't seem to run an efficient administration?